To the town of our free, who rode a stranger one fine day.
Hey guys, Mason here. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to get the ultracite armor. And if you don't know, ultracite armor is this boy. It's also like really powerful, but there are a few requirements and it's kind of like a lengthy process to go and get the armor. So you need to be level 50, and that's at least. You can be higher and get it, but you can't be lower than 50. And every time you get the piece of armor, it's not guaranteed the armor is going to be 100 durability. Like, it could be sometimes like near broken, like some of mine is. Alright, so actually, at the end of this armor, the whole quest line is the Brotherhood of Steel quest line. Or its little segment in this game to get it. So what you're going to want to do is start by traveling from the vault to the top right of the map to add a compass. Pretty much just a dangerous area too, so you don't really want to come here unless you're already like well established in the game. Once you're here, you're going to come across this little bunker from the road. This little bunker will have a terminal to open it, and sometimes the doors just open, like how I found it. Overseer cache with some stuff. You go inside, and you're going to want to enter Abby's bunker. I already completed this, obviously, so I'm not going to be able to show you what it says exactly. And this is based on, like, my memory of it. But what you're going to want to do is go inside of Abby's bunker. Alright, so once you've entered Abby's bunker, there's a staircase with glowing fungus. And you keep going down. Now, there's sometimes rad roaches like there is now, but the first time I came here, there wasn't. Let me just clear those out. So, from the staircase, you go through the door here. She's gonna talk to you. She's gonna say you need to find some stuff, and ultimately, whatever she says, you can ignore, because who really cares about that? What you need to find is her terminal. There are some other terminals here, like, I don't know how to say that, but Mirages, and there's desk fans and stuff you can take. But I don't need any of that right now. It's good for, like, gears and screws. You're going to want to take a left here, and then go in through. Go to the left, go into this left door right here. And here's Abby's terminal. In this terminal, you're going to want to click on Fort Defiance. Learn about that. You're going to get the quest. And then it's going to give you a whole nother objective. She's going to talk some more. You're going to have to go completely a ways from here once you're done looting it. You're going to have to actually head your way down to probably Camp Venture. I've known some people where they do the quest, they automatically skip and just go straight to Fort Defiance. But I'm going to show what you do if you go to Camp Venture. Yeah. Alright, so once you were here at Camp Venture, you made your way south. Got here. There's going to be some scorched and ghouls. Maybe just ghouls or scorched. I don't know the spawn rates on these, but take those out. Won't be that hard for you. Probably, if you made your way there. Here, I'm going to go up and bash these. Alright, so once you've made your way into the camp, the Brotherhood of Steel symbol, you will want to Let's see here. Let's get around to the other side. Make your way up here. And there's some scorched. These guys are harder. It's gonna be quite a challenge to get through here if you don't have the proper things, but if you just have a simple gun, you can take it out from range. If you're being mean, then you're just kind of like not caring about the HP. Alright, so made your way up here. This is the building we need to get into. So you're gonna see this will not let you in. You're gonna need a key card. This will be closed and will not be openable. You can get a storage key though, which is the good news. So there's another guy. From here, there's a building right across. You're gonna want to go into this building, and the locker in the middle on the left. This will be like pocketable, pickpocketable. I mean, pocket with or unlock it with bobby pins. Take the storage key. Once you have that, you're going to want to head back down here into that middle storage building. In the middle storage building, there will be, you'll be able to pop in here, just in that middle storage building, keep going down here, staircase, there you go, and then hop a left, open this up, there's some good stuff here, all that, and what you're really gonna need, there's some rocket launchers and ammo, and it's all fine and cool. You don't need this, the command center password, just take it. I don't think it really matters if you take it, but just take it. Now, make your way back to the initial building, which, let me do that real quick. Now, in this, you're going to be able to go into the terminal, unlock the door with the password, and then you can open this. It will open. There's cool stuff you can loot. There's lockers. There's an ammo box. That's all good. And what you need is this letter to Tommy. And this should give you a quest. Alright, and once you've read the letter to Tommy, you're gonna get a quest that will take you to Fort Defiance, which is the main Brotherhood thing you need to go to. Now, I'm gonna fast travel there. I'm gonna show you what to do inside. Alright, so once you've made it to Fort Defiance, you're going to want to come in through this entrance. There's usually quite a bit of scorched here, and there's usually an event going on. Hold on, line in the sand. This is always here. Fix up some stuff. There's scorched here, so watch out for that. You're just going to pop in straight inside. Go to Fort Defiance. Alright, so once you made yourself inside the building, there's gonna be some loot. Honestly, just always take every chance to loot everything. It's gonna come in handy later on. But the main thing you're gonna wanna do is go straight to the left. This is the door you need to get through, but this will not always be open. See this line attaching to there. Now, you just want to follow this. And if you go over here, keep following the line, you'll see cracks. There will be a thing you need to do up there. And that will... Here. This, if you keep going up here, turn a left, go up, remember to follow. I guess it's not showing, but remember to follow it as you can. And I've ran into a glitch where it sometimes just opens by itself. It really isn't that hard to get open, or it usually is open by itself, honestly. That's the first time I came in, it was open by itself, so maybe you get lucky, maybe you don't, I don't know. Alright, you go through here, and you see this. This, you're going to want to read that. And this will get you to the next part of the quest. Alright, so the quest will lead you to go. So, pop out of here, go right, turn another right, and this door. This door will have red lasers, sometimes they're purple if you're bugging out. Red or purple lasers cannot get through. So, what you're going to want to do is, from here, I got really confused on this, by the way, but I figured it out eventually. So what you're going to want to do from here is read the letter, get the quest, go straight, turn a right, go up this stone ramp, turn a left, or actually, turn another right through here. There's something following me. So go right, forward, some more shit. Oh. That was weird. Alright, so keep going forward, up the stairs. Keep going forward, and eventually you, yeah, go right, another forward, go through here, right again, and this, once you go forward into here, to the left, this is going to be the thing you need to do, this thing where you register new personnel. It's going to be like, oh, it's not going to work. And people are going to be like, oh, okay, well, you got to figure out your own thing now. So, you are going to need to pick up a thing of another sister of battle who went here. So you're going to want to go from here. The terminal. Go east, I guess, and then just go into this room. Good stuff to loot in here, I guess. You could do all that. And you're going to want to pick up this. Squire Evelyn's journal. There should actually be another thing here. Alright, so once you've picked that up, it's going to tell you to go back here. Go to the terminal. And it's still not going to work. And it says you need a military valid ID. So, on the map, from the vault, you're going to want to go to Camp McClintock, this camp-looking area next to Flatwoods, and, New River George Resort, at Camp McClintock. I'll fast travel there now. Alright, once you've made your way to Camp McClintock, you're going to want to go here and go up the stairs. And this will be like a whole mini quest line of itself. Go through here. Talk to this. Alright, so you talk to them. It takes you through three training courses. Agility, Patriotic, and Marksman, they're really not that hard, and there's one more that, like, you have to kill robots, and the last robot's kind of difficult, but still shouldn't be a problem. I don't know why I went here. So, once you've done that, you get Soldier's Certification, which you just saw I picked up. And Soldier's Certification is actually what you need, so. You'll do that. And from there... Alright, so once you've done that little quest line, it should be self-explanatory from what the person's saying. You will need to go to the Charleston Capitol building. So fast travel there, or just go explore there if you haven't already. Alright, so once you've made your way to the Charleston Capitol building, we are going to need to get into the DMV. I'm gonna get some water. Okay. Let me just deal with this real quick. Alright. So, since you're here, I don't know if you'll be coming from here, but just make your way to this building. Follow the track. There might be supermutants and feral ghouls up here. So just watch out for that, I guess. They're not a big problem. They're like level 5, I think level 10, 5 to 10. Head into the DMV. Alright, so now that you're in the DMV, it will tell you to talk to one of these boys.
Please wait for your number to be called.
And it will say some stuff. You're gonna need to get your validation through here, and this is a pain in the ass. So I'm gonna try to remember as best I can. I may get some stuff wrong, but it's not hard, it's just very tedious to try to do this shit. So. Alright, so once your thing has been called, it will tell you to put in the DMV number terminal. You're gonna wanna hit boot up department B, and from there you'll have to wait until your number is called. Ghouls are gonna come at you from here, not that hard, well, 5 to 10, I'd say. Talk to him. He tells you, your validation's not, you know, it will be understood. And you need to get a, dealio. I think an important thing I actually missed before that was you need this. That totally just skipped my brain. Alright, so you're gonna need the government ID, this. Get that, and everything. And then talk to the robot, and then put that in there. I messed that up, sorry about that. Once you've done that regardless, you're gonna wanna come back outside. And, back outside, you're gonna wanna find a junk mail in a mailbox, and that junk mail will have, like, an address on it for, like, verification. I can't remember if it's actually an address or what it tells you, but it's something to do with validating your paperwork. You're gonna need to find it. You are out of the DMV, the junk mail, so follow this path, go right a bit, and from here, just keep playing with this green mound. So we'll build this mailbox. It will have your junk mail in it. I already grabbed it, but it will say junk mail. So it will have like a saw on it. Once you're done, back into the DMV, will tell you you need another thing. And I'll show you another thing now. Alright. Once you've done that, turn that in, you're gonna need to come. It's not too far from when you started following that. Gonna need to go through this little trash hole, turn right, and go into the building of the courthouse through here. Alright, once you're here, there will be a lot of ghouls. I mean, ghouls and scorched. I think just scorched, actually, I didn't even say ghouls. From here, just go left and deal with this. Alright, so alright, go here, take a left, office of the registrar. Now you're not required to, but you can like pot, you can go down there and do that, but you can just press E to get it. And then easy, now you just get out of the building. And you go back to the DMV. Alright, so once you are back out, go into the DMV. The DMV. Yeah, you're gonna have to talk to that guy, and then it's gonna show you that, oh, it's the wrong guy. You're gonna wanna talk to the C-bot. And the C-bot, there's a B and C. C is on the left, and then C was the right bot all along, so. Following the quest should honestly instruct you enough, but now you're going to need something called the governor's seal, and the governor's seal isn't something that obvious to find, but you can get it through going to the DMV, talk to this bot, C-bot. You go through this little crack opening, through the door, right, keep going forward. There's gonna be scorched here, not a big problem. Honestly, really not. Really low level, actually just like XP. They're really not even worth wasting any of the time on. There's a little bit of them, but they're all one shot. I mean, I think even if you have like a switchblade, you can do something with that, like three shots. Might kill them. Just clear all of them. Alright, so I'll go back so that's easy to understand. This guy. Where is he? Alright. So just to backtrack, we go from here to the next door. Actually, we're going through there and go here. Turn a left, or not a left, turn a right. Going forward, and then go left. Right. This hallway. I don't think it actually really mattered, but whatever.
Made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 20 past 11.
Alright, so make your way back to Fort Defiance. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody. some scorched here.
Not really a problem. They don't really come inside. In there.
And inside Fort Defiance. Now, if you take your way back up to the terminal to register a new profile, you will validate that, and then the thing will open. It will turn blue. You can go in through that upstairs door, or you can go in through this bottom stairs door. I'm going to be walking through the bottom stairs door.
So this is done. Open this. Left. Go here. I'm going to right again. This will be blue. You want to open the door. Go to the fourth level. And now you've made your way up here.
Alright, so it's going to give you some, another quest item before you can get it. And this one's slightly more difficult. I don't want to go back and do it all, because I'm very lazy. That, and it's just a lot of walking for unnecessary reasons I've already done. So I'll try the best to show you on the map. Once you've done that, it will give you a quest. It will search for radio frequencies in three zones. There will be a big orange circles on the map spanning from here all the way down to here. And to do that, you're going to go to radio and do, there's some Brotherhood of Steel radio thing you can select, and then it will get closer, and they all have different things. Like in the city, there's one with the helicopter crash, and then this one, there's one with like a little kind of incline, and there's a concrete, and then a thing. Next one's at drops IV9. Then you're going to be taken to the glassed cavern. Now, this is where it gets kind of difficult. You're going to want to go through that cavern, go through all of those levels. It's going to be pretty difficult because I had a hard time on all that. Like, just the things there. Pop in. Keep going forward. It should be really self-explanatory which way is forward, but, you know, if you get a little lost, I recommend looking up a more in-depth guide. I don't know if there is one, but go through there. Do that. You're going to reach this end area, and in the end area, there is a Scorch Beast. You're going to loot the Brotherhood Responder's corpse really quick, and then radio into the last radio frequency in that cave next to the Scorch Beast, and then just run out of there. You don't need to fight it. It's not required. Now, once you're done here, once you're done there, I mean, take your way back to the fourth level. That cavern will take you a little bit. That is this whole quest. My server crashed in the middle doing it too, and it reset my progress. It was really not a fun time, but gonna make your way back up here. And there will be power armor that can spawn. It's not where you're looking for, though. Really. Take your way back here, up here. Turn in the quest, which it will have that marker over it that I have right now. It will give you an armor chassis. And it will be this, actually. You get some good Brotherhood of Steel armor. You get some good Ultracite armor. Any durability. And this armor is very nice. I'm actually still using some Brotherhood of Steel armor pieces for my character, and the Ultracite armor is absolutely amazing. It's
not as good as XL1, obviously, but you can't really beat XL1. But it is very good. It gives you 513 defense, 453 energy, and 463 radiation, so that's about it. I skimmed over the glass cavern because it's something I really don't want to do again or go through again, but there will be a Scorch Beast. You're going to have to kill that, and I mean, you're not going to have to kill that though, so that's the good part, and that's about it. So if you enjoyed, just show it by liking the video. If you didn't, comment why, and if it's just about, like, how you get through the glass cavern, it will be very self-explanatory. You'll go there, and it doesn't require a lot of human thought to function to do that. It's just following. You may get lost a little bit one way. I think it splits, but that should be really easy to get through. And that's about it. I'll see ya. After Texas Red, wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a